I am going to talk about continuing what we talked about last week, which is chipping. So chipping, let me get a sandwich here. Okay. So chipping, again, by my definition, is how we release our hands. Okay. So when we release our hands, if our hands is leading the club head through impact, and you can flip or roll after the ball is gone, after impact, which really doesn't matter, and that is chipping. Okay, now when we chip, if we place a golf ball in front, have the ball slightly open, and still use that same technique, you can chip the ball high, okay? Or obviously, you can chip the ball low. Okay, I don't know if you guys saw I shanked that one, but I hope not. All right, so that's me chipping it low. So, but anyway, so by my definition, that is the chipping. It's how we release our hands through impact, okay? Pitching is when we allow the hands to catch up, when we allow the club head to catch up with our hands and release through it, okay? So that's pitching. So I can pitch it low. So this is me pitching it low, allow the club head to catch up with my hands. And this is me pitching it high, allow the club head to catch up with my hands, okay? So the difference is I can still chip it low, chip it high, pitch it low, pitch it high, but the difference is how the hands work through impact, okay? So if you listened to me last week already, you're like, Hong, you're repeating yourself again, but I'm sorry, I had to repeat myself. Make sure everybody understands what I'm trying to talk to you guys about. So now, the reason I think I said this last time, that I like to teach chipping because it promotes a good impact position. It actually will help you understand what a good impact position is when you do a full swing. So we're going to continue that. So what is a good impact position? A good impact position is when we strike the golf ball, okay, our hands is actually leading the club head, is in front. Obviously, we would love the club face to be square, okay? From the down the line view, okay? If this is us setting up to the golf ball, down the line view, your hands actually will be slightly raised because there's a down force when we swing down, and that will raise your hands up, okay? And on the front view, back to the front view again, okay? That your hands and arms leading it, okay, coming down through impact, okay? And then your right elbow, okay, is not released like this. It's actually tucking this way a little bit, okay, with that face, trying to get that face square, okay? So it's not like this. So whoever said that, hey, you want to bring your impact is the same as setup, please run away from that person as fast as you can, okay? Whenever you hear that, please run away, go find somebody else. But impact should be, hands is ahead of a club head, okay? Right elbow sliding this tuck position. This is actually shoulder external rotated, okay? And then your left arm should be, the elbow should be pointed towards the target a little bit, and this is actually left shoulder internally rotated, okay? So that's what a good impact is. But when we talk about chipping, and I'm really just talking about hands and arms right now, I'm not really even talking about bodies yet. So when you chip, literally you can actually force yourself into a good, you know, impact position and through, just by understanding what's good, what's bad. Now, one thing I want to add to what we just talked about is, I have given a lot of lessons over the years, and because of in the 80s and 90s and probably in the early 2000s, we have an instructor on TV always loved to talk about getting the wrist fully hinged early in the golf swing. Now, if you are really talented, you can probably do this, but for most people, if you do this, because there's so much tension between the shaft and the left arm already, and in the wrist, that you want to release that tension right away, okay? And guess what happened? If you do that, you have what we call early release. So I actually don't like to do that, And I like to teach somebody that you, if you swing back, you actually have very passive or minimal wrist hinge going back, okay? So that way, we're actually gonna try to teach you to learn to increase that wrist hinge on the way down, get the face square, and strike it, okay? So that's what we would like you to do. So that's an extension from the chipping, okay? So a lot of people that I've talked to has two issues. One is early release, and when you early release, a lot of times that you have your wrist hinge so full at so early on the backswing that this creates so much tension, and this thing wants to release out because there's so much tension that has been created, and that's what created that little early release. That's why you start losing lag, okay? And another thing is because hinging the wrist, if you hinge your wrist correctly, now some people will feel like I didn't hinge the wrist enough, so I'm adding more. So if you notice this, that in the back on my left hand, this thing is cuppy, okay? Wherever that is cuppy, that means that face is open, okay? So by us forcing us to hinge more, we actually open the club face, okay? So what end up happening from that is so you are releasing early and then you have opened the club face. Guess what? That's just a formula for disaster in the golf swing. So what I'd like to talk to you about today is when we swing the club back, as a drill, if you don't feel comfortable doing this in full swing yet, just go ahead and do this as a drill and utilize this more or less as maybe a three-quarter swing, a half swing. And then hopefully a little bit later down the road, we can extend that into a full swing for you, okay? So when we swing the club back, I want you to feel like this shaft is actually almost in line with your left forearm, okay? It's okay to have a little wrist hinge, but right now most people actually overhinge or hinge way too much on the way back, okay? So I want you to feel like it's in a straight line, okay? And on the way down, okay, so on the way down, what that means is my body and my left arm start moving towards the downswing, okay? And when that happens, you notice that how I actually let my hands actually create a little hinge. So this is almost like a little down cock action, and this really happens in the downswing. Not in the backswing, then start down, okay? It's happening in the downswing, and when you swing out down here, when the shaft is about parallel to the ground, check your back of your left hand, make sure the back of left hand is straight. So if you have a good grip, the back of the left hand is straight, that means that club face is square already, okay? So a lot of practice is almost straight, shaft, you know, left arm, creating a little hinge. Your checkpoint is right here when the shaft is up parallel to the ground. Make sure the back of your left hand is flat. So that means your club face is square, and then go swing on through, okay? So if you do it together, it will look like this. Here, square. Square, good, okay. Now, so that would be a good way for you to work on this. You might not hit it as good, but at least you're doing the breakdown, you're doing the right things, okay? Do that again, okay? Shaft ball straight back through, even with club, bring down here. Make sure that you create a little more wrist angle here, and then that face is square, okay? So, all right. So that's what we're trying to do here. Excuse me. So hopefully that helps you, but that will start creating a good habit for you of getting your hands ahead of the club head, creating a little more wrist hinge on the way down, and then holding on through impact, and obviously also getting the face square. Okay. So those are the basically a continuation of chipping. But that will promote the better golf swing for you. Now, if you start working on this and then going, hey, I did really, really good. How do I incorporate that into my full swing? Unfortunately, to incorporate that into a full swing, that will be a little bit harder because for us to achieve that, you know, the easiest way for me to explain it, if I just simply making a baseball-like movement here, anytime my body stop rotating or slow down, my hands will cross over. So anytime my body stop rotating or slow down, my hand will cross over like this. So I just have to make sure that my body is rotated as I go through impact. So that will actually have to more to do with how I can get your body in the right position to support what we just learned in your hands and arm. So that will be another time, but at least you should be able to do this all the way from chipping to half swing. Some people might be able to do that in three-quarter swing right away. Okay, so feel like not very much wrist hinge going back, create a little down cock, okay, make sure the face is square and swing through, okay? It's a very good way to make your practice swing just like that. And just go ahead and hit the little half swing shot just like that. Nice catch. Okay, so that would be a good way for you to go practice. And that will help you promote that little hands leading the club head through impact feel again. So